All right, thank you all so very much. Welcome to T-Mobile Arena here in Las Vegas, Nevada for the 2024 UFC Hall of Fame induction ceremony. I'm John Anik. Once again, it is my distinct honor to play host to such a special evening. Each of our 2024 inductees will receive our traditional trophy signifying entry to the Sacred Hall, as well as the signature UFC Hall of Fame black jacket custom made by Maceo.
Pessoal, quero agradecer primeiramente a Deus por tantas conquistas, tantos prêmios, tantas bênçãos. Deus me abençoou com muito mais que eu imaginava, que eu sonhava.
First of all, I want to thank God for so many accomplishments, so many wins, for so many blessings. God has given me so much more than I've ever expected.
Pessoal, quero agradecer também todo o pessoal do UFC que me ajudou ao longo desses 16 anos. Fiquei no UFC, só no UFC foram 16 anos. Eu passei por muitas pessoas do staff, cutmans. Então, eu sempre fui tratado com muito carinho e amor pelo todo mundo do UFC.
And I'd like to thank everyone in the UFC, all the staff, everyone that works in this organization. Now, I went through a lot of people in the staff dealing with me, cut men, everybody, always treating me like home. 16 years in the UFC, and all I have to do is thank all of you.
Murilo, se eu estou aqui hoje, é graças a você. Se eu conquistei todas as minhas vitórias, meus títulos, meus prêmios, é graças a você. Você é o maior casca-grossa que eu conheço. Você é o lutador mais valente que eu conheço, cara. Parabéns, eu tenho orgulho de ser seu irmão. E eu quero convidar você a vir aqui comigo receber esse prêmio, que esse prêmio é nosso. Murilo Ninja, vem aqui, por favor.
Murilo, if I am here, if I got the accomplishments that I did, if I got the wins and the titles that I did, it was because of you. You have been an inspiration to me. You are the biggest bad I've ever seen. You are the most, the bravest fighter I've ever seen, and I'm very proud to be your brother. And I would like you to share this moment. Please come up here, Murilo.
When it comes to charity, charity has to be, it has to be from you. It has to be something that God leads you to. It can't be one of those things you just write off. You give the money to someone and you just forget about it. It's got to be personal. You got to have relationships. You got to know who you were working with, and you got to have accountability. And so, with that being said, that's allowed me to stay in Haiti and continue to do the works we've done. You know, if it wasn't for the idea of love your neighbor as yourself, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't care about a whole lot, to be honest with you, if it wasn't for that. With that being said, it doesn't happen outside of Jesus. I haven't seen it anywhere else. I have not seen hope that is never ending. I have not seen hope that never runs out. I have not seen hope except outside of Jesus. So today, my message is this. Get to know him. Thank you, guys. Thank you for having me.
It almost is like rinse and repeat. Here we are. Bunch of fight fans, fight capital, cameras, a show to save, and here comes Chael. What did they introduce me as when I came out here, by the way? I was talking to my good-looking son over here, doing a little shadow box. This guy's getting ready for the 2036 Olympic Games. You might want to keep your eye on that. What did they introduce me as? The American gangster, the show saver, the show stopper? What did they say? God damn, were you all falling asleep up here? Then they bring me out here to induct me into the Hall of Fame. Well, it sounds like to save the Hall of Fame. And I know what you were all thinking. God, I hope this guy stays. Oh, we miss that guy. Chael P., undefeated and undisputed, beat a champion from every organization there's ever been. Pride, UFC, Strikeforce, Bellator, King of the Cage, Gladiator Challenge. I beat the guys down at the Rumble at the Roseland. I beat every guy that's on the stage tonight. They got a monitor in the back, and if there's one of them back there that disagrees with it, they can walk up here and we'll qualify that statement right now. But before we go, I really came here to remind you of one thing. Hard times don't last. Dreams do come true. Bad times don't last, but bad guys do.
Eu nunca pensei que isso ia acontecer. Realmente é uma grande honra ser reconhecido por tudo que a gente fez pelo esporte.
I never thought this was going to happen, and I think it's a great honor to be recognized for everything that we're able to do for the sport.
Realmente, a academia, quando comecei a treinar na academia, a academia era uma academia muito dura, uma técnica muito realmente muito agressiva.
When I got to the gym the first time, I got to a very hard gym. The technique there and the training, it was very aggressive, let's say.
E quando eu estava lá no meio de mais de 300 alunos, eu tinha muitos caras que eram muito melhores do que eu.
You know, when I was there, it was like 300 students there, everybody just there, and the many of them were way better than I was.
E eu nunca achei que eu ia conseguir chegar aonde a gente chegou.
And I never thought that I was going to be able to get to where I got.
Às vezes eu nem tenho palavras para agradecer, sabe? O suporte de todos vocês. Muitos de vocês já me acompanham por mais de 20 anos. Então, olha, do fundo do coração, muito obrigado.
Sometimes I'm out of words to say thank you for everything that you do. So many of you have followed my career for over 20 years, so from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Wow, I'm too young for this. But guys, thanks for coming. Thanks God. One more thing, dear everybody, whenever you are a fighter, an artist, scientist, businessman, you name it, every craft requires discipline. For many years, I have said that it is the hard work that leads me to great success. But still, you can never, ever run off faith. Faith that you can succeed. Faith should be with you the very last moments, you know? And if someone tells you again that you don't deserve something or that you can't do, you just do it. You just do it right away. Whenever you rise or fall, keep doing your thing and let your legacy speak for you. Dream on, dream until your dream come true. Guys, it was a pleasure. Thank you so much. I hope you're gonna get some from the message. Thank you, guys. Thanks for the support, and I love you all. I love you all.
This isn't something I dreamed about. In fact, it's something, this shouldn't even happen. I always like to call myself the undersized overachiever. I should have never been a champion. I shouldn't be up here talking to you about being put into the Hall of Fame. It wasn't talent that got me here. It was all the hard work, showing up to practice, putting in the effort. Being an underdog suited me, and it was more about determination than anything. It was a stubbornness to succeed. There's so many people who helped me along the way, so many people who've put their love and faith in me, and who've dedicated themselves to helping me achieve everything I did. I love all you guys that are here with me tonight. You mean everything to me. I wasn't blessed with super talent or power or great size or speed. What I had was hard work, determination, and belief in myself. It carried me to the UFC. It carried me to a UFC championship as an undersized lightweight and carried me to the Hall of Fame. Kids, believe in yourselves because that belief goes a long way. Your old man's proof. Thank you all.
With that, we present to you the UFC Hall of Fame class of 2024. Thank you all for coming out. We'll see you Saturday night live back here at T-Mobile. Thank you all for being here and for making the UFC the undisputed leader in combat sports. Good night.